So far we have talked about steady state, mass balance based modeling of metabolic networks, and our focus was small scale metabolic models so far. So it would be better to focus on small scale models to better convey the idea behind the concepts. So that's why our focus was small scale metabolic models. From now on, we'll talk about genome scale metabolic models. And today I will first talk about SPML concept. I will talk about Cobra Toolbox, Groby Solver, and I will make an introduction to genome scale metabolic models. So there isn't a comprehensive course book when it comes to genome scale metabolic models, but I think the only best source is Systems Biology book, Constraint Based Reconstruction and Analysis by Bernard Paulsen. So if you are interested in, you can follow this book. As I said, there isn't a book for a course book for genome scale metabolic modeling. So if you want to learn more, review papers are really good. So I have listed here some of the key papers, review papers on genome scale metabolic modeling. Some reviews are really early, from 2004, some from 2012. There are many more to come, but these are talking about the basics, more basics of genome scale metabolic modeling. So you may want to read those papers. Now I'll talk about SPML format. SPML is a file format, and SPML files have XML extension. This XML is closely related to HTML, the format for web pages. And so similar to HTML files, those XML files are machine readable. They are not human readable. So if you open them, you will not understand anything because, as I said, they are not human readable, they are machine readable. They are preferred because of easy file exchange. There are many different softwares that deals with metabolic modeling, that deals with metabolic networks. Each of those softwares were coded such that they can read SPML inputs. So having a standard input format such as SPML makes it easy to transfer models from one software, one application to the other application. SPML was introduced in 2003 via this paper published in Bioinformatics. By the way, the open form of SPML is Systems Biology Markup Language, a medium for representation and exchange of biochemical network models. The paper was cited more than 3,000 times so far, and now SPML is the standard file format for many metabolic network modeling approaches. Now let's look at inside an SPML file. As I said, it is not human readable. So this is what you will see if you open an SPML file. You see some, maybe you see some keywords which are familiar to you, such as reaction, you see here, gene association, you see here, lower bound, upper bound, objective coefficient. You see some similar terms, but it is not clear. But if you look closely, indeed, there is a systematic way of storing models in SPML files. For example, here you see the reaction ID. So this information is for the reaction named RACACT1R. This is the open name for the reaction. So this is an ID for the reaction. This is the open name for the reaction. So for the reaction, for that specific reaction, first some information is given. So it's enzyme EC number, for example. It's gene association. The enzyme is associated with, the reaction is associated with gene B2221. So this gene makes an enzyme with EC number this, and that enzyme catalyzes this reaction. And the reaction belongs to membrane lipid metabolism. Then comes the definition of the reaction. So list of reactants is used to define the reactants of the reactions, the substrates of the reactions. Each definition in SPML format starts with a definition line, as you see, list of reactants, and it ends with a similar, almost the same text, but this time with a slash. So it means that section finished. List of reactants section finished. So within this list of reactants, we see the names of the reactants. So this is the name of the reactant, acetylcoenzyme A, cytosolic. And we see its stoichiometric coefficient. So the reaction is 2, acetylcoenzyme A. This is the substrate, reactants. Then comes list of products. Starts here, ends here. Again, you see slash here. Each line represents a different species. So species here means metabolites. So 2 acetylcoenzyme A goes to AA-CoA plus CoA. So this is the reaction. Here the stoichiometry is not given. This means that it is the default stoichiometry, which is 1. So this is how you would represent this reaction in SPML format. Also provide additional parameters regarding this reaction. So you can define lower bound, upper bound, for example, for the reaction. If it has a value, you know, measured value, you can provide it. You can also provide what is the coefficient of this reaction in the objective function. So for each reaction in the model, you will see this, the same information repeating. So when you open the SPML files, you will see that it includes thousands of lines because each reaction is represented by almost 20, more than 20 lines. You don't have to bother yourself in understanding those. As I said, many softwares today, they can get this input and they can read it and they can convert it into an understandable format. So they can make a stoichiometric matrix out of this SPML, for example, by reading it. And they can construct lower bound and upper bound vectors automatically.